Hi all, welcome to the world of GK for any general knowledge. Today, let's learn a new topic from biology, food and nutrition. I have already covered many important topics. Please watch them in the playlist of the world of GK. Subscribe the channel, enable the bell icon to get all the notifications. Let's start. Biology, food and nutrition. First, let's see the definition of nutrition. The process of taking in food and using it for growth, metabolism and repair. This is the definition of nutrition. Now, let's see the nutritional stages. There are 6 stages of nutrition: ingestion, digestion, absorption, transport, assimilation and excretion. So, ingestion, digestion, absorption, transport, assimilation and excretion, these are the 6 stages of nutrition. Then nutrition is broadly divided into 2 types. So nutrition is broadly classified into 2 types: autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. The mode of nutrition in plants, autotrophic nutrition. The meaning of auto is self. So, autotrophic nutrition means self nutrition. So, food is prepared by the plant itself using the method photosynthesis. So, autotrophic nutrition we can see in plants, and in plants food is prepared by photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is the process by which the plant is making food using the help of oxygen and sunlight. Chlorophyll also take part in this photosynthesis. Organisms that use chemical energy to prepare their food are known as chemoautotrophs. Some organisms that use chemical energy to prepare their food, they are known as chemoautotrophs. The word chemo means chemical. And the examples are nitrifying bacteria and sulfur bacteria. So, nitrifying bacteria and sulfur bacteria are the examples of chemoautotrophs. That means it uses chemical energy to prepare their food. Next is photoautotrophs. Organisms that use sunlight to prepare their food are known as photoautotrophs. So, green plants are photoautotrophs. The organism that cannot make their food and mainly depend on green plants are called heterotrophs. Hetero, the meaning is other. Hetero is a Greek word. Its meaning is other. So, heterotrophs are the plants that depend on green plants for their food. Heterotrophs are of 3 types. Heterotrophs are 3 types: saprophytes, parasites and holozoic. First, let's see what is saprophytes. Organisms that derive their food from dead and rotten materials. So, sapro, the word means dead or decay. Sapro is a Latin word. Its meaning is dead or decay. So, the organisms that derive their food from dead and rotten materials, they are known as saprophytes. For example, bacteria, mushrooms, yeast, bread mold, etc. These are examples of saprophytes. Saprophytes help in cleaning the environment, because they derive their food from that rotten materials by decomposing it, and it helps in the cleaning of the environment. Next is parasites. The organisms that live on or inside other living organisms to derive their foods. Parasites are the organisms that live on or inside another organism to derive their foods. They cause harm to the host. Parasite cause harm to the host. Examples: Cascuta, Loranthus, Balanophora, Sandalwood tree. So these are the examples of parasites: Cascuta, Loranthus, Balanophora, and Sandalwood tree. You may have doubt whether sandalwood tree is a parasite or not, because it's a parasite. Why? Because sandalwood has modified roots named Fusteria, which penetrate the host plant and draw nutrition from them. So we can surely tell sandalwood tree is also a parasite. All the other things, Cascuta, Loranthus, Balanophora, they are also parasites. Next is holozoic. Holozoic means organisms capable to ingest, digest, absorb, and assimilate food. So holozoic are the organisms, they can ingest, digest, and absorb and assimilate food. That organisms are called holozoic. Example: man, animals. So man and animals are examples of holozoic organisms. So that's all about today's class. Hope you understood the video. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, and share to all.